YouTube, what's going on, guys? Back with another video, and today I am at Shingle Creek Trailhead. This is actually, the funny thing is about this particular trail, I've never been on it personally, but it's right behind one of my middle schools that I support for my job, so I'm familiar with the area. I just never been on this particular trail before. After reading a little bit about it, it looks like it's a pretty easy going trail. It said that it was a 4 mile loop. Not sure if it's a complete loop, if it's going to completely loop right back to the start or not, but we'll see, check it out. And so yeah, man, just want to bring you guys this video. Not sure how long it's going to take. If it is 4 miles, I can probably ride that in about 30 minutes, so hopefully it won't be too long of a video this time. And yeah, so hope you guys enjoy. Like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you on the trail in a few. Thank you.
I got you. How's it going?
Enjoying the ride.
Huh?
Enjoying the ride.
Yeah, that's cool out here, man. Appreciate it. You too, man. End of the line. This water is crystal clear. It's pretty back here, man. Basically, this trail is just a little loop. It's really pretty. I don't know if the camera's picking up, but some big fish in this little river. Like some water is coming this way on the river. I don't know if you can see. Another water source is entering in here. And there's some big fish in here. All right, cool. I'm gonna head on back. All right. Let's do it. Trees are tight, man. I didn't even want to chance it because I have no protective gear on this time. All right, let's go. I'm falling. Excuse me, thanks, man. Sorry guys, one more time. Sorry about that. Good. All right. thanks. Appreciate it.
She's friendly.
Oh, okay, cool.
So, the Shingle Creek Trail, it's short, but it's pretty cool. So, what happened was, when I first entered the entrance that I went into, I just followed pretty much the beaten path. And it took me to that bridge that you saw me kind of have to do a turnaround, because it was a gate that was blocked and locking it. So then the only trail I saw was pretty much where those big power lines were out in the field. I followed those until I got to the flooded road where I couldn't go anymore. And so, and there was a lot of water. If you saw, there was lily pads on top of that water. So it looked like it was at least four feet deep, could be even more. And so I wasn't even gonna try to go through that. And so I turned around to go back, and then when I got to the bridge that I originally got off of with the stairs, I saw there was another path going that way. So I followed that path, and it went down probably a good, I don't know, maybe mile. And then that's when I got to the end where I showed you the clear water and the fish in the river. And then I just turned around and came back. So I'm not sure exactly what I read. I'm not sure what it was talking about, a 4 mile loop. I don't really know. It looks like it's a lot shorter than that. Maybe because of the road that was flooded, I didn't get to see everything. I'm not really sure. But so to me, actually, it was pretty fun, the last half of it. I didn't mind it at all. I probably would come back, probably to take a friend or somebody who's just starting off. But yeah, pretty decent trail, pretty cool trail. So nothing crazy, no ramps, no big drops or hills or anything, not too high elevation. But for the most part, it's just getting out on a Saturday and riding my bike. So anyway, hope you enjoyed the video. Check you out next time.